What's going on, you guys? It's the Borderlands guy, and I'm back with another video, and today I'm going to be showing you guys one of the best Moe's builds ever. I love this Moe's build. It's helped me out a lot in Mayhem 4. It's been a lot of fun, and it is not a grenade spamming Moe's build. I see a lot of those. I see a lot of them where it heavily relies on splash damage, things like that. This is not one of those, and I'm really happy to bring it to you guys. I'm very excited, but please keep in mind this is just my opinion. You guys might not love this build, but it works really well for me. That's why I'm bringing it to you guys, but you guys might not like it, so just let me know if you guys don't like it, but be respectful. I am entitled to my opinion just as much as you are to yours, so be respectful. And before we hop into the video, be sure to check out my other main channel, JDO, which is linked in the description below. I post 3 times a week, very consistently. Love doing videos over there. I have a lot of fun. I do other videos other than Borderlands, but I also do Borderlands video, and I decided to start this channel so I could do only Borderlands videos. So be sure to check out both channels and subscribe to both channels. And without further ado, let's hop right into the video, baby. Alrighty, so here we are with my level 57 Moe's build, and let's go over a couple of things first. The first thing I want to talk about is the items and the weapons you're going to be using. So first off, let's start with the weapons. Now, any high magazine weapon is going to be doing you so much good with this Moe's build. Any weapon in general, you will honestly do well with, but the ones I highly recommend to do the best with is, I love the Soul Render. This thing is really, really good. It's really good. I love it a lot. It works very well for this Moe's build. I also love using an Old Ridian. I love using a Shredifier. I like using the Lob a lot, and I will go more into detail about these guns in a little bit. Any high magazine weapon is just going to do you so much good, and any fast firing weapon that has a high magazine will do you a ton of good. The only two things out of these little 4 items right here, out of the grenade mod, the shield, the artifact, and the class mod, that really matter are just the class mod and the artifact. These are the only 2 things in this build that are absolutely dependent. If you want to be doing what I'm doing in this video with Moe's, these are the only 2 things that are absolutely dependent. The sapper is the class mod that you need, and also the Pearl of Ineffable Knowledge. Now, both of these come from the new Guns, Love, and Tentacles DLC. The Pearl of Ineffable Knowledge you actually get by just completing the entire story line. Claptrap gives it to you during the storyline of Guns, Love, and Tentacle DLC. He literally just gives it to you as a mission reward, which is absolutely awesome. This artifact is unreal. The class mod can drop really easily, just as a world drop from that DLC. I've gotten plenty of sappers. The sapper is super awesome. It's super easy to get from the new DLC. So just go play it, kill some enemies, do some side quests, farm some enemies, whatever you'd like to do, and you most likely will be getting the sapper. The reason that this is so good is because the sapper, Moe's gains up to 12% life steal. The longer she holds down the fire button, the greater the life steal. This is how you're going to be regenerating your health just by shooting, and this is absolutely unreal. This is where all of your health is going to be coming from. This is why this build is so overpowered. This is how you can pretty much not die just by shooting. It's unreal. Now, the Pearl of Ineffable Knowledge is just going to be giving you extra stack damage. You're going to be having a couple of skills that you respec into that will give you stacks, and doing extra damage to those stacks is unreal. And then also, consecutive successful hits grant 1% increased damage per hit up to 15 times. At a maximum stacks, add an additional 90% damage. That's unreal. That is doing an unreal amount of damage, so you really want the Pearl of Ineffable Knowledge, and you really want the sapper. So those things are just required for this build. Everything else is pretty much just whatever you want. You can put whatever grenade mod you want. You can put whatever shield you want. I like using the Transformer. I personally don't even use grenades because I just don't need to. So you can use whatever grenade mod you want, but I like Transformer the best for the shield, but use whatever works best for you. Now let's hop into the skill tree. This is the best part of the entire video. So let's start with the Shield of Retribution skill tree. So you're gonna put 5 points into Armored Infantry. While Moe's shields are active, she gains damage reduction and increased gun damage. This is really important. This is really nice. While your shields are active, you're doing a ton more damage. Very self-explanatory, very awesome. The next skill you're gonna do is Vladolf Ingenuity. Moe's maximum shield is increased, and she gains resistance to shock damage. Absolutely unreal skill. Being resistant to any shock damage is awesome, and your increased maximum shield capacity is really, really nice as well. Drowning in Brass. This is the first stack that you will come across. Kill skill. Killing an enemy grants Moe's a stack of Drowning in Brass. For each stack of Drowning in Brass, Moe's fire rate is reduced, but gun damage is increased for both her and her allies. This is unreal. This stack is really, really really good. You can do so much gun damage, and it does plus 20% gun damage per stack, and you can stack this a lot. It's really unreal. I love it a lot. It's worked really well. You can find yourself doing mass amounts of damage, so you'll want to spec 5 points into that, and then this mixed with the Pearl of Ineffable Knowledge, you're just going to be doing so much damage. It's crazy. You're going to put a point into Full Can of Whoopass. Entering Iron Bear causes Moe's and her allies' shields to immediately begin recharging at an increased shield recharge rate. Self-explanatory, very nice. Plus 25% shield recharge rate is always nice. Put 1 point into Experimental Munitions. Whenever Moe's and Iron Bear scores a critical hit, they deal bonus incendiary damage. Very nice. You always want to be doing extra damage, and incendiary damage is pretty nice to have, so let's just put 1 point into that. You're going to put 3 points into Desperate Measures. Moe's gun damage and Iron Bear's hard point damage are increased depending on how low their health is. The lower the health, the greater the increase. Amazing. Up to 50% more damage the lower that your health is, which is really, really good. I like this a lot. And because you are going to be shooting to regain your health, if you ever find yourself in a situation where you have really low health and you need to shoot, as long as you just shoot, you're going to be doing a ton more damage because you have low health, and then you're going to regen that health, which is really awesome. You're going to put 5 points into Phalanx Doctrine. This is another stack, kill skill. After killing an enemy, Moe's gains a stack of Phalanx Doctrine. For every stack of Phalanx Doctrine, Moe's maximum shield and gun damage are increased. Each stack lasts 30 seconds. There is no stack limit. This is one of the most overpowered things that you're going to be specking into in this tree. You definitely want to put 5 points into this. Because there is no stack limit, you could stack this as much as you possibly can. Killing 10 enemies within a 30 second duration pretty much will give you 100% more gun damage and 150% more of your maximum shield. It's absolutely unreal. And there's no stack limit, so you could just keep on stacking that over and over and over. And I promise you, after you get some more stacks, you will definitely notice this. And then this mixed with Pearl of Ineffable Knowledge, you're going to be doing so much damage. It's unreal. So yeah, this just mixes really, really well with all of your artifacts and just everything. All the kill skills mixed with the stacks doing extra damage is just unreal. Then you're going to put 1 point into Tenacious Defense. Whenever Moe's shield is fully depleted, she instantly restores a portion of her shield, and her gun damage is increased for a short time. This skill can only trigger after Moe's shields have fully recharged. This is really, really good. It's going to be just make it even harder for you to go down. Once your shield goes down all the way, you get a portion of it back, and you do a ton more gun damage. 30% more gun damage. Now, this mixed with all your kill skills and everything like that, you can potentially do a ton more damage. Like, with all these kill skills active and all the stacks doing more, you can do up to like 400% more damage with your guns, which is just absolutely out of this world. Now, let's go into the green tree. This is the one that's going to be helping you to not ever have to reload. So, start off by putting 5 points into Cloud of Lead. Occasionally, Moe's and Iron Bear shots will deal additional incendiary damage and will not consume ammo. Occasionally, you're not going to be consuming ammo. We don't really do this for the incendiary damage. It's just the occasional non-consumption of ammo. Put 5 points into that one. Next, you're going to put Matched Set. You're going to put 5 points into this one. Moe's currently equipped weapon gains a stacking bonus to magazine size and decreased heat per shot for every piece of equipped gear that has a matching manufacturer. This is really good, very self-explanatory. Bigger magazine size and decreased heat per shot, so very good. Put 5 points into Scrappy. While moving, Moe's handling, weapon swap, and mode switch speed are increased. This is really, really good. If you're moving and you're running and you're trying to swap weapons, it does it almost 50% faster, which is absolutely unreal. If you're in a position where you need to swap guns really fast, you can swap them very fast, which I like a lot. Put 1 point into Redistribution. After Moe's scores a critical hit, she regenerates ammo for a few seconds. Absolutely unreal. You're just going to find yourself regenning more and more ammo. Once you find those critical hit spots and you start nailing them, you're going to pretty much never reload as long as you're hitting critical shots, which is unreal. Put 3 points into Stoke the Embers. Increases Moe's and Iron Bear's incendiary damage. Again, extra damage is always good. Plus 30% incendiary damage is really nice. I like that a lot. I like how you can increase your incendiary damage with Moe's. I think it works out pretty well. Put 1 point into Russian Offensive. Moe's can sprint and shoot at the same time. Now, this is all 100% opinion based. If you don't want to sprint and shoot at the same time, I completely understand. I found it really annoying at first, and honestly was kind of, it felt like I was going a lot slower. I didn't find much use for it anyways, because I was so used to never being able to sprint and shoot at the same time. I never found myself actually doing it at first. So if you don't want to do this, then just put this point into the one right next to it, Scorching RPMs. Just put the extra point into this one if you don't want to run and shoot at the same time. Just put 3 points into this one. So Scorching RPMs, Moe's gains increased fire rate and critical hit damage. Iron Bear gains increased hard point damage. Just going to increase your fire rate and increase your damage. The reason we're not specking into this one all the way is because we want to get to the bottom bottom of the skill tree, and I just put the leftover points into this one because it was good enough to put leftover points into, but it's not good enough to spec into all the way. So the one right below it, put 5 points into the iron bank, increases Moe's magazine size. This is unreal, almost 50% more magazine size. This is just going to make it so you literally don't have to reload. You're going to have so much ammo inside of your magazine that it's going to be hard to reload. So for something like the Shredifier that has 100 bullets and the increased 50%, that's going to put you over 150 bullets. And because of my Scrapper class mod, I have an extra 2 points into this one, which gives me more of a magazine size. Unreal, this is just going to really help with your never having to reload. Put 1 point into some for the road. Moe's gains infinite ammo for a few seconds after exiting Iron Bear. This is unreal. You exit Iron Bear and you literally don't have to reload. You don't even consume any ammo. Absolutely amazing. But this is the reason we spec to the bottom of the skill tree, is Forge right here. Moe's constantly regenerates ammo for her currently equipped weapon. Unreal. This is absolutely unreal. If you have your weapon out, you are constantly regenerating your ammo. It's unreal how well this works. It's the reason you want to spec to the bottom of this tree. It blows all the other skills out of the water. This is why this build works the way that it does, is because of Forge. If you like to use Iron Bear, I actually really enjoy using Iron Bear. A lot of people just hop out of him as soon as they deploy him, just to get their anoints and stuff like that. But really, I actually like using Iron Bear. I highly suggest using the minigun with the explosive rounds for your Iron Bear, but you can use whatever you want. That's just what I use for my Iron Bear. Then we don't put anything into the blue skill tree. The only reason I have one right here is just because of my class mod, but you don't put anything into the blue skill tree. This is where all the splash damage comes into and stuff like that. And that is what I avoided with this build. I really wanted a build that did not heavily depend on spamming grenades to regenerate health and spamming grenades to do splash damage and things like that. I wanted a Moe's build that didn't rely on that. So that is the skills. Those are the skill trees. Those are the items you need for Moe's to work. Let's put it into action. Let's check it out. All right. So real quick, just so everyone knows, I am in Mayhem 4. The modifiers are pretty much normal. So let's hop right into this. Let's start the Slaughter Shaft and I'm going to show you guys some damage. All right. Look at that. You guys can already tell I'm literally like, look at my ammo fighting so hard to just to regenerate. But look at this. I'm pretty much not having to reload at all whatsoever. My magazine size is staying relatively in the same area, especially if I score critical hits, and I'm regenerating my health just by shooting bullets because of our class mod. Again, that's one of the most important things, is to be able to regen your health just by shooting your bullets. Look at my health fighting so hard right there. Look at that. It's real trooper. My health is fighting so hard for me right there. Look at that. Amazing. It's so good. I mean, look at that. Look at all that damage from all the stacks that I've been accumulating and just things in general, and just I can absolutely shred through some guys. Look at that, man. Absolutely unreal. The best part about this build, honestly, is just the fact that you can't really, as long as you're shooting, it's really hard for you to go down. And when you do, because of all your stacks and everything like that, it's just pretty easy to get right back up. Like, it really, it's just amazing. Like, look at that. Just shredding this tank. Absolutely doesn't even know what hit him. Just boom, look at that. Boom. Alright, that's pretty much it. That is it for my build. Thank you guys so much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and share. I'm so glad I got to bring this build to you. If you guys have any issues with it, or if you have any recommendations, anything like that, let me know in the comment section below. Let me know if you guys like this build. I just really am happy I got to bring it to you guys, because I hate all the builds where it just talks about spamming your grenades. That's just not my playstyle. I don't like doing that at all. So I'm really glad there's a Moe's build that doesn't require doing that, and this is a lot of fun. It does really well in Mayhem 4. You almost never have to reload, and it's just a lot of fun seeing all of your stacks come together and things like that. So my name is the Borderlands Guy. Be sure to check out JDO, which is linked in the description below. That is my main channel. I post 3 times a week over there. I have a lot of fun on that channel. Be sure to check out both my channels, subscribe to both of my channels, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Peace out.